आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन लेसन टू ऑफ कंप्यूटर. लेसन टू ऑफ कंप्यूटर इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग विंडोज. येस्टरडे आई हैड सेंड वन वीडियो ऑफ लेसन वन. ऑल माइट हैव सीन दैट वीडियो. नाउ यू हैव टू सी दिस लेसन टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग विंडोज. यू विल ओपन योर बुक, यू विल रीड द चैप्टर 2-3 times. Then you will watch the video, then only you will understand. Now understanding Windows. Now first you have to understand what is Windows. Windows is not that window which you see in your homes. It is not that window. Now what is Windows? In your home, who controls all the work of your home? It is your parents. Who controls the work of your home? All the work, all the things. Whatever you have to buy, whatever work has to be done in your home for cooking food, washing clothes, who do all this work? Your parents. Parents control all work of your home. So like that in computer, who controls whole work of the computer? This whole work of the computer is controlled by operating system. Who controls all the work of the computer? It is operating system. And this Windows is an operating system. This Windows is known as operating system. So all the work which computer has to do, whatever you do in computer, like you watch movie, you play games, you do painting work, typing work, whatever you do in the computer, it is controlled by operating system. And this Windows is an example of operating system. Today most of the computer which we are using all have Windows in that. And there are many versions of Windows, like Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, like this. Different versions of Windows are also there. So this was all about Windows. Windows is an operating system. What is Windows? If I will ask you what is a window, you will say Windows is an operating system which controls all the work of the computer. And this operating system has two types of interface. It has two types of interface which are given in your book also. Two types of interface. What is interface? Interface is an area from where user interact with the computer, from where user use the computer. Two types of interface are there. One is CLI and second one is GUI. CLI means command line interface. And GUI means graphical user interface. So operating system has two types of interface, that is CLI, command line interface, and GUI, graphical user interface. What is an interface? Is a part from where we access the computer. Like you see this mobile phone. In this mobile phone, this screen is your interface. Like when you open the mobile phone, in the mobile phone you can see so many icons are here. So many icons are here. When you click on any icon, what happens? That icons is open. So this is known as interface, from where we use the device. We are using this device from this screen, from by touching these icons, these images, pictures. So this is known as interface. So there are two types of interface, CLI, command line interface. In CLI, command line interface, we don't see any picture, images or any color, nothing. We have to type that text. Text means alphabets and numbers. We have to type that text, then it will work. Then that computer will work. We don't have any buttons to click or any option or any buttons or any images are not there. For for doing any work we have to write the command. So that is known as command line interface. And graphical user interface means where graphics is there. Graphics means buttons, pictures, images are there. We are clicking and then we are using. That is known as graphical user interface. Like this computer is there. In this you can see these buttons are there. You click here, this button, these icons are there. So this is your graphical user interface, because in this you can see options, images, icons, everything is given. So this is your graphical user interface. And what is command line interface? In command line interface, like this, this is your command line interface. Like this, you have to type, then you have to work. This is command line interface. Here you can see only black screen is there and alphabets are there, no picture, nothing. So this is known as CLI, command line interface. When this type of operating system is there, that is known as CLI, command line interface operating system. And when this type of screen is there, this type of screen, that is known as graphical user interface operating system. So two types of interface I have told, CLI, command line interface, and GUI, graphical user interface. So operating system has two types of interfaces, CLI and GUI, which are given in your book also, using which we interact with the computer. Next topic given in your book is Windows. So Windows, I have already told what is Windows. In your book Windows 7 is given. So what is Windows? Windows is an operating system. Already I have told, Windows is an operating system using which we interact with the computer. Like I have told, it has two types of interface, CLI and GUI. So using this operating system, we interact with the computer. This controls your computer. So Windows is an operating system. Some features of Windows is also given in your book. Like, what are the features, means what are the good qualities of Windows? It is very attractive. It is attractive. Attractive and colorful. It is very attractive and colorful. Windows 7 is very attractive and colorful. It is very easy to use, means anyone can learn how to use Windows 7 computers. It has search tool also. In Windows 7 you can search your files and program. Multitasking or multi-user, it is multitasking system, or you can say multi-user system. Multitasking means it can perform many work at one time. Multi-user means 2-3 person can use the computer at one time. So these are the features of Windows 7. So you have to read these features from your book. It's given in your book. Now next one I'm going to tell, that is desktop. Components of Windows 7 I'm going to explain. Now next topic in your book is desktop and its component. So first you read this from the book and then I will explain this. So what is desktop and its component? First component is given icons, and next one is taskbar. Two components are given in your computer. One is icons, like when you open your computer, when you on your computer, the first screen which appears, that is known as desktop of the computer. This first screen which appears when you on your computer, that is known as desktop of your computer. And it has some small icons on that. Like this, you see some icons. These are known as icons. Here you see one horizontal bar is given. That is known as taskbar. and it also has one start button. This is also one component of desktop. It has one start button that is also present on the taskbar. Now I am going to explain this on computer. Now see, this is your desktop of the computer. When you on your computer, the first screen which you see, that is the desktop of your computer. This whole screen is known as desktop of the computer. You can see one background image on the back side, that is known as desktop wallpaper. Now see, you can see these small pictures are given like this. These are called icons. What are these small pictures called? These pictures are called icon, and this part you can see, this horizontal bar is given, this horizontal bar, this is known as taskbar. And you can see it has one start button. This is your start button. You can see here it is written also start. This is your start button. When you will click on this, you can see all the programs of your computer. This is your start button, and this is known as taskbar. And on the taskbar, you can see some icons are there. These are program icon, like this one you can see. This is of paint. You can see paint is written here. Next one, Google Chrome. This is of Google Chrome. So these are the programs. These programs also you can put on taskbar. Suppose I click on this. So you will see MS Paint will be opened here. You can open the MS Paint. This MS Paint is opened here. So by clicking on these programs, you can quickly open any program from here. And this part is also known as quick access toolbar. This part is also known as quick access toolbar. Why? Because quickly by clicking on any icon, you can open any program from here. And this part of the taskbar is known as notification area. This part of the taskbar is known as notification area. Here date and time is given, battery symbol is given, network symbol is given, and other properties are also given here. So this part is known as notification area. So taskbar has three part. This part is known as notification area, and this is start button, and this is your quick access toolbar. And when you open any program, like here I have opened this one, so what you will see, I have opened MS Word. See, you can see the MS Word icon is placed here. This is the icon of MS Word. You have opened MS Word on your computer, so MS Word icon is shown here. So whichever program you will open, that icon will also appear on the taskbar of your computer. So all have understood, this first screen of your computer is called desktop. This small pictures are called icon, and this is your taskbar. Now next topic given in your book, see in your book the next topic which is given, that is basic operation on the desktop. This is the next topic given in your book. So first you read this topic, then I am going to explain. In this so many things are given, selecting an item, this also I will tell. Deselecting an item, arranging icons, sorting icons, and after that opening a program. These all are given in your book, so one by one I will tell what is that and how to set screen saver. This screen saver is also given, how you will set the screen saver. Now selecting an item, this means that on the desktop these icons are there. So how will you select this? I will tell you on the computer. How will you deselect? That also I am going to tell. Arranging icon means, suppose you want to arrange these icons in a proper order. So for that also some options are given. You can arrange the icons. Sorting icons means like ascending, descending order you want to sort, like small one you want first, or name wise you want to arrange, so that is known as sorting. Sorting means arranging in descending or ascending order. Opening a program means how will you open any program in your computer. Screen saver, how will you set screen saver? Now what is a screen saver? A screen saver is simply an image which comes on your computer when your computer is not working for some time. It is open, your computer is on, you have left your computer untouched, you are not doing any work on your computer and your computer is on. So what happens at that time, one image comes on your computer and it is moving here and there, that is known as screen saver. Next one I am going to tell, that is selecting an icon, selecting an item. Now see, how will you select an item or an icon? Suppose these already I have told, these are your icons. If you have to select any icon, like I want to select this one, my computer, so what you do, you bring mouse here and simply click one time. Now see, this is highlighted, this is highlighted in blue color, this means your icon is selected. So selecting I have told, suppose you will, whichever icon you want to select, bring your mouse over that, simply click one time. See, it's highlighted, so this means this icon is selected. Now deselecting means if you want to deselect it again. Now see, it is selected, that's why it is highlighted in blue color. You, if you want to deselect, then click anywhere on the desktop one time with the mouse. See, anywhere you will click, this will be deselected. Again I am telling, this time I am selecting this one. See, bring your mouse over this, click, see, it is selected. Now you want to deselect, bring anywhere, suppose mouse is here, click here, anywhere on the screen, see, it is deselected. So this is known as selecting or deselecting an item. Now next one is arranging the icon. Suppose I am putting these icons. Now see, these icons are spread all over the screen, means one is here, 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 and one is here, one is here. See, they are not arranged properly. See, icons all are spread on the whole screen. Now you want to arrange these in a order, as you have seen before, you want to arrange that in a line, in a order. How will you do? Now see, it is given in your book. You will right click with the mouse. You can read in the book also, steps are written. Right click with the mouse, then go to view. This view option is there. Then here you can see one option is given, that is auto arrange icons. This option is given, you can see in your book also it is given, auto arrange icon. So what you will do, you will simply click on that auto arrange icon. See, as soon as I will click, all the icons will be arranged in a order. This is known as auto arrange icons. Now next one is sorting the icon. Sorting the icon means arranging them in a proper order. Now you want to arrange in a ascending or descending order. Now see, these icons are not in a order, like A is here, then D is here, then C is here. They are not in a order. Now I want to arrange them according to a order. So again, right click with the mouse, go to this sort by, sorting, you have to sort, so you will click on sort by name. It, here so many options are there, name, size, item, date. Name means it will arrange according to the name, like A alphabets will come first, then B, then C. Size means which are smaller, they will come first, then the bigger ones will come. It will arrange according to time, it will arrange according to date. So I am selecting here name. Now see, your icons will be arranged according to the name. Means A alphabets will come first, then B, then C. So by this option, right click, sort by name. If you want to sort according to size, now this time I am selecting size. So this will be arranged according to the size. So like this, you can sort your items. Sorting means arranging them in a proper order. Now next one given in your book, opening a program. Now if you have to open a program, two steps are given. Simply suppose I want to open any program.
So I want to open this program. This program. What you will do? You will double click on this program with the mouse. You will double click. See, this program will be opened on the screen. Okay. Or I want to open any other program. Like I want to open this one. Double click with the mouse on this one. See, it will open this program here. So like this you can open the program. Next step for opening the program is that you click on this start button. You will click here on the start button, and then in this box you can search your program. Like I want to open Paint, so I am writing here Paint. I have written here Paint. See, this Paint has came. Click on this. This MS Paint will be opened on the screen. So two methods are there for opening the program. One is that if you have shortcut on the screen, you can directly click on that. You can open from here, or you go to start button, and from here you can search your program which you want to open, and then you can open from here. Now next one, I am going to tell you how to set screen saver in your computer. This screen saver is also given in your book. See, what is screen saver? Screen saver is simply an image which will come on your computer if you leave your computer untouched for some time. See, how will you set screen saver? You have to right click here. This menu will come. These are called menus. You will go to this last option, personalize option. You will click on this last option, personalize option. Then see here, screen saver option is given. You will click on this screen saver. And from here, you have to choose one screen saver. Like here, I am choosing this one, ribbons. See, like this ribbons are coming. I am choosing this one. And here, time I have chosen 1 minute. And then click on OK. Now, what you do? You leave your computer untouched for 1 minute. Now, I am leaving this untouched for 1 minute. Now, you can see the screen of your computer. You can see like this ribbons are coming. So what you do, you have set the screen saver. You have left the computer 1 minute untouched. You are not touching your computer, and which screen saver you have set. Now see, this will automatically come on the screen. Now I am going to press a button. Now I am pressing the button. See, screen saver will go. Again, if you don't do anything on your computer and leave it untouched for 1 minute, again screen saver will appear on the screen. So this is screen saver. Now next thing I am going to tell, that is desktop gadgets. Now last topic of your chapter is desktop gadgets. So I am going to tell you about desktop gadgets. Next one is desktop gadgets. So I will tell you how to apply this desktop gadgets in your computer. Now what are these gadgets? Gadgets are mini programs in your computer. These are mini programs, like clock is there, calendar is there, or puzzle is there. Like these gadgets are there which you can apply on the desktop of your computer. On the desktop of your computer, you can apply these gadgets. Now I will tell you how to apply these gadgets in your computer. Now see, how will you start gadget, how will you apply gadgets on your computer? Simply what you do, you right click with the mouse, right click with the mouse, and here you can see this option is your gadgets option. This gadget option, you can see, you will click on this gadget option. And this window, you can see in your book also this picture is given. This window will be opened, and these are different kinds of gadgets like calendar, clock, CPU, meter, currency, feed, headlines, Intel, picture, puzzle, slideshow, weather. Like these gadgets are given, and some gadgets work when your internet connection is there. Otherwise these will not work. Like if I will select this weather, this will tell the weather only when internet connection is there. See, it is written here, cannot connect to service because internet connection is not there. I am applying this calendar. See, this calendar will come. It will tell the date, day and month. Like watch, clock I am selecting. So this clock gadget will come. Like picture puzzle I am selecting. Picture puzzle. So like this, these are gadgets of your computer. These mini programs. And if you want to change, you can change their settings also. Settings of the gadgets, different types of settings, different types of clocks are there, different styles. You can choose any from here like this. You can change. If you want to remove this from your computer, see one cross symbol you can see here. One cross is given, simply click on this cross. Like this gadget here, you can see this cross is given, click on this and this will be removed from your computer. So these are the different types of gadgets which are present in your computer.
So I think all have understood, and I have shown you also on the computer how will you do all these things, how will you apply this to your computer. You can practice that, and you will read the chapter 2-3 times, then you will watch the video, then only you will understand it properly. For any confusion, you can contact me. Thank you.